your way, it just tastes better.
We're back now in the third round, and let's get you caught up. We talked about Brock Huard to Seattle. Since that time, Chicago has picked Marty Booker, wide receiver, Northeast Louisiana. Dan Campbell, tight end, has gone to the Giants from Texas A&M. Martin Gramatica, 65-yard field goal for Kansas State. Kicker, third round, Tampa Bay, and Tampa Bay is hoping that they are grammatically correct and not incorrect with this pick, Mel.
Well, he gets good initial elevation on his kickoffs. Has a live foot, Chris. And you mentioned that field goal, 65-yarder, the longest in NCAA history without the benefit of the tee. He also had a 55-yarder against Indiana State. This pick, look at the elevation. Initial elevation, outstanding. Not a lot of kids block when you get that ability to get the ball off the turf as quickly as he does. This is an outstanding kickoff, well out of the end zone. Most of his kickoff distance, good, not great. Usually between the 5-yard line to 3 or 4 yards deep. Yeah, this is the 65-yarder coming up here against Northern Illinois. So you know, phenomenal range. Wasn't quite as consistent this year as he was in 97. Missed a chip shot, 7 to 10 from 40 to 49 yards, 22 of 31 overall. So when you look at Martin Gramatica, great leg strength on field goals, adequate on kickoffs, not as consistent this year, but the kid showed during his career, it's one of the latter stages, Joe, he can kick in the National Football League.
Bill Parcells, one of the most respected coaches in our league, and he talked about one of his priorities when he was with the Jets this year. He says, we need to get Tom Tupa. I needed to get a punter. He knows the value of a good kicking game. So does Tony Dungy. With Gramatica now, you've got a kid who looks like he can kick the ball off for you, put it down the field a bit. As you mentioned, gets the ball in the air real quick on field goals and extra points. So you wind up improving your kicking game. I don't think enough emphasis is placed on the value of a good punter, in bad weather in particular, let's say in the New York area, or in a kicking game, which Tony Dungy will have now in Tampa Bay. So I like this pick. Maybe a little high for a kicker, people say, but I don't think so. I think you have to understand the true value of kickers.
It's the best name that Tampa's had a kicker since Donald Igwebwikwe, I think.
Igwebwikwe?
Igwebwikwe or Obed Oriri. You know, they've had some
great
names.
Another Scrabble guy.
Zach Piller, tackle, Florida, has gone to Tennessee. I like the Scrabble guys. In Seattle, just taking a wide receiver in Carson Bailey.
I'll tell you what, he's got ability, Chris. You know, he's got the physical skills, good size, 205 pounds, sturdy, can take a hit and get up and go out for more damage. I think 150 career receptions at Auburn, and offense that always didn't throw the football tremendously well. Damian Craig, most of the way, though, did a good job. I think when you look at Carson Bailey, decent hands, not great hands. I think that's what you're going to look at. You see some excellent catches here, not quite as consistent at times for his career, fought some passes. But when you look at Carson Bailey, size and speed, I think that's what is interesting. A team like the Seattle Seahawks at this stage of round three, because he basically had late first round computer numbers. I think the lack of consistency at times pushes them into the third round, but I think for Mike Holmgren, you're getting a guy here, physically what you're looking for. Sturdy frame, outstanding straight line speed.
Just a note, when Piller went a couple of picks ago to Tennessee, that made him the fifth Florida Gator, and that's the most thus far. 10 different SEC schools have been picked, everybody but South Carolina and Mississippi, but Florida has 5 picks already, and we're not even done with the third round. But we're getting there. Mike's ordering dinner right now.
It began as the product of meticulous Japanese design, but it was sent to Europe for finishing school. It was tested on Austria's Alpine roads, refined on Germany's autobahns, and chased on England's racetracks. Now the car that's proven itself in Europe is crossing the pond. Introducing the all-new 99 Infiniti G20. Born in Japan, educated in Europe, now available in America.
Where am I going?
Whatever happened to simple?
You know what I wish?
How can we sell more cars?
More books.
More stuff.
What will it take to build this company?
To beat this disease. When do I get to play? The quality of our lives depends on the questions we ask, which is why we at Compaq have worked to put more power and more tools into the hands of more webmasters, more CIOs, more people than any other computer company. So they can find more answers. Better answers.
How can I make my mark?
Compaq. Better answers.
With all the attention McGuire got last year, I got jealous. So this year, I'm going for the record. Maybe instead of the big unit, they'll start calling me the long unit.
As we welcome you back to the draft in New York, 83 picks done. Pick 84 is on the way right now. We're going to join Sal Palantonio in Cleveland. We've talked about the Browns' selection up at the top of both the first and the second rounds, and Tim Couch and then Kevin Johnson, their picks later on. One has a little bit of an interesting story that requires a little further digging. For that, we'll join Sal with the coach of the Cleveland Browns.
Okay, thanks, Chris. You've had a first successful day drafting, but let's start off with Raheem Abdullah, linebacker out of Clemson. He had an off-the-field brush with the law last month, reckless conduct, carrying a deadly weapon, discharging a weapon in public. What's your understanding of where that case stands right now?
It's our understanding after we researched it, it is a misdemeanor. He's hired a lawyer, and the lawyer has talked with our people, and there is a court date set. So I don't know where it'll end, but I know that the people are talking, and it should be taken care of.
You've investigated his background. Are you happy that he's put this stuff behind him?
Yeah, we are. We've talked with the people at Clemson. We've talked with the coaches down there. They assure us that he's a fine young man, and it just is a situation that occurred, and hopefully he's learned a lesson from it.
Now, in rounds one through two, let's go through your draft. Tim Couch, obviously, was your pick at quarterback, and then you went out and you got a wide receiver, Kevin Johnson. Tell us about Kevin Johnson. Where does he fit with your football team?
We're going to play Kevin at the split end. He's an explosive player. He's a versatile player. He's played in the backfield. He's played quarterback. So we think we have a guy that can return kickoffs. He's led the Big East in kickoff returns. So we think we have a player that can come in and contribute, whether it be as a starter or as a special teams player right away.
And Daylon McCutcheon, you said all along you wanted to get yourself a cover corner. Can McCutcheon come in right now and you know, push for a starting job?
Well, again, it's open competition, but he's a guy that's started the last 39 games at Southern Cal, and that's excellent football. He's a guy that, you know, very easily could go in and play in the nickel situation. He's got cover ability, so we're very pleased to have him.
And in the last pick, Marquise Smith, a safety.
Marquise Smith is a big hitter. He's a guy that every year has gotten better at Cal. Our people have talked to the people at Cal. They love him. A very physical, knock people down. With the running backs that we have in this division, we have to have a safety that can make some tackles.
And then you got 8 picks on Sunday, so you've got a lot of work ahead of you.
We'll be here late tonight trying to stack the board and go from there, but we're very pleased with what's happened the first day.
A successful first day for Chris Palmer and the Cleveland Browns. Now let's go back to you.
Okay, Sal, thank you. So that's Chris Palmer not only breaking down this first day ever for the new Cleveland Browns, the 99 Cleveland Browns in their draft, but also the one issue with Raheem Abdullah. There's another off-the-field incident that's cropped up over the last 24 hours regarding not a new player in the league, but a more experienced veteran player. For that, we bring in Andrea Kramer, who joins us now from Minnesota. Andrea.
Yes, Mike, you're right. On a day when the Vikings are so optimistic about their draft, some sobering news about free safety Orlando Thomas, who was just signed to a 4-year, $11 million contract extension in February. In a statement issued by Sheriff Ken Goss of Crowley, Louisiana, Thomas was arrested and charged with domestic violence at approximately 11:30 Friday evening. He was released on bond. His wife was treated and released from a local hospital. The case is being forwarded to the district attorney for prosecution. I spoke to Dennis Green about this. He said that he was aware of it. He had not had the opportunity to speak with Thomas yet, but the main thing is the hope that Thomas and his wife were okay. I also spoke to a league official who told me that just being charged and arrested triggered the NFL's violent crime policy, which would send Thomas into mandatory evaluation and counseling. If Thomas was subsequently convicted, he would be fined and could receive additional sanctions at the discretion of the commissioner, which could involve suspension. So yes, Mike, some off-the-field news, unfortunately making news here.